Bala, and it's on sinus augmentation. Please start talking.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yeah, yes. You're audible.
Ma'am, my topic today is ma'am, minimal invasive transalveolar sinus augmentation for posterior implant rehabilitation. Ma'am, I have demonstrated three different techniques which we are using these days to procure this treatment. This is Summers osteotome technique, which was initially used. It had a limitation of 5 mm of residual bone height. Then came ma'am DAST, which we have been using extensively now. It uses this principle of hydraulic sinus lift to place the graft, and there is no such limitation of residual bone height. And Versa, Densar drills by Versa, they create a reverse, by reverse stroking, they create the lift of the sinus and also osseodensification. Ma'am, I have demonstrated three cases. We can see the whole concept of the grafting works on the past principles. That is the primary wound closure, the scaffold creation that we do by bone grafts. Here on, we can use alloplast bone graft. It also creates a very nice, and it is economical, abundantly available, and has a very, very nice result. Angiogenesis, yes, maxilla has very good angiogenesis potential, and stabilization of wound by Schneiderian membrane in itself, because it creates a closed space. So it creates a better healing perspective for sinus. And as we know that sinus has a very high osteogenic potential, that has been demonstrated multiple of times, and by these modern methods, the results have become more predictable, less trauma to the patient, and the acceptability of the treatment has also increased. Plus, it also helps us to avoid prosthetic complications, such as nowadays we are doing pterygoid implants. We have to tilt the implant. It leads to many, many prosthetic complications like use of multi-unit abutments and other factors. So these are my case presentations. We can see I am trying to zoom in actually. So first case, we can see there is we have used an osteotome with a stopper, and we have lifted the sinus and we have placed the bone graft. Second, we have used to perforate the sinus floor by the specific drills used in DAST kit. Then 80 millimeter of implant was placed, and this is the post-op x-ray after 6 months. And third is Versa by Densa. I'll be very quick. This has been taken from the internet. The rest two pictures are mine, but Densa by Versa has been taken by internet. We can see how beautifully the scaffold has formed and there is bone formation. I should end my presentation.
Dr. Aman, Dr. Pritesh, you have Dr. Aman also with you, right?
Yes, ma'am. I'm here, ma'am.
Yeah. So I have one question that the technique is really good. You have mentioned the advantages, you have mentioned the technique, but what is the relapse rate? Is it different from the other sinus augmentation techniques, or is it same?
Ma'am, I think so. Ma'am, I don't have an article to quote about this, but out of my clinical experience, ma'am, I don't feel that there has been much of a relapse rate in comparison. Once bone is formed, it's formed. And ma'am, yes, an augmented bone is always soft. It is always soft. And we are doing it in the posterior region. It will be always D4 bone. So we have to do a progressive loading of the implant. We have to be very, very careful regarding the prosthetics. Basic, ma'am, the whole concept boils down to the good prosthetics with zero guidances, good, ma'am, occlusal forces, and very well, ma'am, prosthesis is the main function in the grafted bone.
I would like to add that out of these three techniques, we found none to be better than the other. All three were equally good. It's all about the costs, like Densa costs, then DAST costs. But the cheapest and the best technique, we believe, is the Summers osteotome technique.
Yes.
Otherwise, in the results, all the three were same.
So any complications did you get?
Ma'am, complications, ma'am, the perforation of sinus membrane is the biggest complication. But we have to check it by Valsalva maneuver, ma'am. We put in the saline solution, we do the Valsalva maneuver, and we try to see the perforations. Ma'am, it is a blind procedure. Sinus lift is a blind procedure, ma'am.
Okay.
So we try to find out more and more of how to see the perforations, and then we would have to go for either a direct technique or even do a staging of the grafts. Right?
Yeah, always a direct sinus lift is better, but it is like always a complicated procedure to create a Caldwell loop window and visualize the sinus. So in indirect sinus lift, we are always blind.
Yeah, thank you guys. Dr. Spurti?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was about to tell Dr. Raman, that in comparison to your direct sinus lift, indirect sinus lift is not that technique sensitive. But however, the Densa burrs are much more sought after burrs now than compared to, as you said, Summer's technique is really good. But I would also like to know, in this case of your own, why did you opt for a bone graft in Summer's technique?
Ma'am, I did it, ma'am, just to be safe, ma'am. Nothing else, ma'am. It was just for the safety precaution, ma'am.
But do the evidence suggest that you would require to place a bone graft in an indirect sinus lift, or would you not prefer to do that?
Ma'am, the basic concept of the evidence is that we just require to do the tenting effect.
Exactly.
Graft or no graft. Ma'am, bulky graft creates more of troubles. If it slips into your nasal cavity, ma'am, it creates all those, ma'am, inflammatory reactions.
Absolutely.
And then, ma'am, all things trickle down to more complicated.
Pritesh, me and Dr. Pritesh have over 100 such cases documented with us.
Okay. 100 such cases of placing the graft, you mean?
Sinus surgeries.
Yes,
sinus. Okay.
So what about PRF in your sinus lift procedures?
Ma'am, I am very I cannot say that I believe, but ma'am, I don't think so. Ma'am, PRF and PRPs have any role in sinus lifts.
So it's best to keep it nude.
Ma'am, it is best to create a tent.
See, there is a pressure from the sinus air. So the tent will collapse. I mean, because you are perforating the sinus heart tissue wall, right?
Ma'am, I agree, ma'am. Ma'am, my tenting effect, ma'am, I don't have any evidence to prove that, but ma'am, I have placed collagen sponges. Ma'am, normal, the ab gel sponges, they have created a bone, ma'am.
Yeah, that works well. It's been documented. That works pretty well.
Ma'am, actually, but we are in a starting stage for ma'am research and surgeries, ma'am. So we are doing CBCT these days. But ma'am, soon, actually, our basic focus is on ma'am grafting and sinus augmentation.
Okay, Dr.
Thank
Pritesh
so much,
and Dr. Raman. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So we go on to the next presenter, Dr. Soumya Saxena, and they will be presenting on ridge split technique.